You are listening to The Voice of the Gospel, a proclamation of the Holy Gospel by Wisdom Ministries.
January 25th, Monday. Let's begin this day with the blessings of God. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark, chapter 16, verses 15 to 18. He said to them, "Go into all the world and proclaim the good news to the whole creation. The one who believes and is baptized will be saved, but the one who does not believe will be condemned. And these signs will accompany those who believe. By using my name, they will cast out demons, they will speak in new tongues, they will pick up snakes in their hands, and if they drink any deadly thing, it will not hurt them. They will lay their hands on the sick and they will recover." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ. Dear friends, happy feast day. Today, the Holy Catholic Church celebrates the feast of the conversion of St. Paul the Apostle. Dear friends, "For I am the least of the apostles, because I persecuted the church of God, but by the grace of God I am what I am, and his grace toward me was not in vain." 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 9 and 10. This is how the Apostle Paul sums up the significance of his conversion. What happened after that dramatic encounter with the risen Christ on the road from Jerusalem to Damascus is not primarily a moral change, but a transforming experience by the grace of Christ. And at the same time, the call to a new mission to proclaim to all the same Jesus whom Paul used to persecute by persecuting his disciples. At this moment, in fact, Paul understands that there is a real and a transcendent union between eternally living Christ and his followers. Jesus lives and is present in them, and they live in him. The vocation to be an apostle is founded not on the human merits of Paul, who considered himself unfit and unworthy, but on the infinite goodness of God, who chose him and entrusted the ministry to him. St. Paul also bears witness to a similar understanding of what happened on the road to Damascus. In the first letter to Timothy, "I thank him who has given me strength for this Christ Jesus our Lord, because he judged me faithful by appointing me to his service, though I formerly blasphemed and persecuted and insulted him. But I received mercy because I had acted ignorantly in unbelief, and the grace of our Lord overflowed for me with the faith and love, and that is Christ Jesus." The superabundant mercy of God is the sole rationale upon which Paul's ministry is founded. And it is at the same time what the apostle must proclaim to all people. Yes, in the light of the word of God, which we have heard and which has guided us during the week of prayer, for the Christian unity, we can truly say that all of us believers in Christ are called to declare the wonderful deeds beyond the differences that still divide us. Let's recognize with joy that at the religion of Christian life, there is always one call whose maker is God himself. Let us move forward on the path to a full and visible communion among Christians, not only when we come closer to one another, but above all, as we convert to the Lord, who out of grace chooses us and calls us to be his disciples. To convert means to allow the Lord to live and work in us. That's why when Christians of different churches listen together to the word of God and seek to put it into practice, they take important steps toward unity. It is not only the call that unites us, we also share one mission to declare to all people the wonderful deeds of God. Yes, my dear friends, let's join together today with the prayer that Jesus Christ prayed to his Father, that they may all be one, so that the world may believe. Amen. May God bless us. Happy Feast Day.